everybody. Welcome back. In this shot, I'm carving out the area for the space underneath the barrel and for the trigger. While the whole thing will be the same width, there'll be a slight step to it. I'm using a 1/4-inch two-flute carbide end mill. There's no real reason for using carbide, I just happen to have it, and it's the right size. I ended up making another section of this deeper. Like I said, there's going to be a step in it, but apparently I didn't video it. I will make sure, though, that I get a shot of it in a future video. Sorry, that turned out to be kind of a blurry shot. Here I'm just using a 45-degree chamfer tool. There's also a step in the 45-degree angle that I just cut. I'm not actually sure exactly why it's there. I'm guessing it's for clearance, but since the original was that way, I made it that way also. Now I put the same 45-degree bevel on the bottom of the barrel. This bevel is also for clearance. I made it a little larger than it needed to be, but this is just mainly for looks. Then in the frame, I drill the hole for the slide stop pin. Off of camera, I put the slide and barrel in place on the frame, and in that little hole that I just drilled, used a transfer punch to make a little dimple on the barrel so I knew where to drill. A second hole is drilled at basically a 45-degree angle from the first. I then just file off the high spots with a hand file. You might notice there's a slight radius here. I'm fairly certain that it could have been a straight 45 degree angle, but the original was that way, so I made mine that way. But I honestly don't think it makes any difference. This cut is also a clearance cut. The barrel is actually sitting in there at a very slight angle. Here I take a piece of 4140 pre-hardened. I'm going to make a slide stop pin. The measurement that I'm marking here really doesn't need to be that exact because the material that I've got is way bigger than it needs to be. It just needs to be centered one way and offset enough to where there's enough material on the end to finish the rest of it. Now I put it in the four-jaw chuck, and basically align it with the tailstock. Again, it doesn't need to be exact because of the way I'm making it. Now I just remove the bulk of the material just to get it out of the way. After this shot, I realized that I was going to have to undercut it a little bit so there would be material left for another piece of this part that I need to make. This is that same 1/4-inch two-flute carbide end mill I was using earlier. There's also another slight step milled into this piece. The step is to make a retainer for the spring that will move this part back and forth. Now more bulk material is removed. Here's the part I'm making side by side with the original part. Hopefully this will give you an idea where I'm going with this. Well, that's all the time I have for this week. Thanks, guys!